नमस्कार, हार्टी वेलकम टू ऑल नॉलेज सीकर्स टू माय चैनल। दिस इज डॉक्टर मधुसूदन राव कड़प्पा। इन सम अदर वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड मटेरियल्स मैनेजमेंट। इन इंटीग्रेटेड मटेरियल्स मैनेजमेंट देर आर सेवरल फंक्शंस अमंग विच इन्वेंटरी कंट्रोल इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। Now, first let us start with what is inventory. Inventory means the materials which appears in different forms that are purchased and preserved, stored to meet the future requirements. So any material that we purchase and preserve it for future requirement or to meet the future demand is called inventory. Now coming to the classification of inventory, in organizations, inventory may appear in these forms. First one is the raw material inventory. In order to make any product, it requires different types of raw materials. These raw materials may be basic raw materials, like suppose if it is iron or steel, in the form of billets or lumps, or maybe in the form of sheets, rods, like that. If it is using cement, concrete or any other material, then cement, then the stones, chips you may call, or any other material, bonding agents, all these will become raw materials. And some of the components like bearings, bushes, or if it is a automobile company manufacturing vehicles where tires, tubes, wheels, bearings and some other products which are the end products of some other company, it will become raw material for our product. So those are the components. Screws, bolts, nuts, etc. also are components which will become the part of the final product. Next, a part of the inventory will appear in the form of raw material. Then in the ongoing process, production process, at different stages, raw material will be in different forms, that is in semi-finished form. So these semi-finished goods, or you may call work in process, inventory. Next, finished goods. The products which are ready to be sold or dispatched to the warehouses or directly to the customers are finished goods. So until we receive orders to deliver or dispatch the products to the market, till then we have to maintain it in stores. It also forms a part of the inventory. And then spares. In order to run the machinery and in order to maintain the equipment in good condition, spare parts are required. Maybe in the form of gears, bearings, belts, ropes, chains, and consumables like grease, oil. So these are all required for efficient functioning of the machinery. Because if any of the breakdown, machine breakdown causes a total production stoppage, then the production schedule will be disturbed and the marketing plans, everything will be disturbed. So we may not be in a position to deliver the products on time. So spares, these may not become an integral part of the final product, but still this kind of inventory is also maintained in organizations. So inventory may appear in these forms in any organization. Now the next concept is inventory control. Now what if we purchase whatever the type of materials required for the organization without any control over financials or any calculation or any optimization like that, then unnecessarily we will be holding so much of inventory which may become obsolete, may be damaged, deteriorated, and the finance basically will be struck in the form of materials. If it is available, we can utilize it for some other purpose, but all the money, once it is struck in the form of material, it is difficult to convert it into cash. So we must have some procedure to know exactly what is the material required and how much is required and when it is required. So in order to answer these three questions, what is required, when it is required, and how much is required, there must be some process that will control the procurement, processing of the materials. So inventory control is that process which will identify or determine what is required, how much is required, and when it is required. And the objectives of inventory control is to reduce the financial investment. Reduce in the sense to optimize. So we will spend funds only as per the required quantities by carrying out some calculations to arrive at the exact quantities of purchases for different materials, so that we will invest limited financial resources. Then, to facilitate production, neither over investment nor under investment in inventory is good for the organization. So the investment on inventory should be optimal. It should not only minimize the financial investment, at the same time it should facilitate the production. The production should not stop at any point due to lack of material. Even if non-availability of a small component may stop entire production line, it should not happen. So whatever the control on inventory we adopt, the mechanism should facilitate the production process and then avoid obsolescence. Obsolescence means loss of value of a commodity with the passage of time. Suppose there is a change in technology, or there is change in design, or any other reason. If the material or the component which we purchased is not useful further, then it becomes obsolete. So in order to avoid obsolescence, we have to go for inventory control. So these are the main objectives with which any inventory control model is designed. Then coming to the factors influencing the inventory control. See, inventory control is a mathematical tool to determine the quantities of different types of materials and the time at which these are required. So this will depend on these factors. First one is the demand. Demand for the product, or demand for the component or raw material. The materials planning should be such that the required materials for our production process, they may be sometimes imported or may be available locally. According to the price, according to the environmental factors or any other conditions, we should see that the demand, based on the demand to that particular raw material, we have to plan our inventory models. And inventory models are of two types basically, deterministic or probabilistic. And demand to the item of means maybe our product or the raw material, may be deterministic or probabilistic. Accordingly, we have to determine the quantities. Then, number of items. Now, there are two important constraints in inventory management, or one is the financial control, constraint, the other one is the space constraint. We may have enough space or sometimes limited space to preserve the raw materials. If the space is abundant, it's not an issue. But if the space is limited, then number of items plays a very important role here. If the number of items are large and the quantities of each of the item are such that the available space is not enough to accommodate, in such case, we have to optimize the utilization of the available floor space or the cubic space, and accordingly we have to find out the quantities, how much to be procured. Then time horizon. So it is the planning period over which we are determining the quantities of different types of materials. So this planning horizon may be a month, or for most of the models it will be a year. So if it is a annual demand based, the planning period is a year, say. So for a financial year's requirement, we will make plans and then we will disaggregate it to monthly plan or weekly plan, like that. Next one is ordering cycle. Ordering cycle is the duration at which we will place the next order. That means the time interval between two successive orders. And here we come across two models. One is the continuous review model. The other one is periodic review model. Suppose we go for a continuous review model, then every month, say for example, every month we calculate the available inventory of a particular item, and we will fix up maximum level and minimum level for each and every item. Now we will, suppose we find out that the item is available by this much quantity, then we will replenish it to the maximum level. So that is a continuous review model. So we will place an order only when the commodity reaches that minimum value. So continuously we will observe, and once it reaches that minimum value, then we will place the order. Here, in continuous review model, ordering quantity is fixed, but the time interval between two successive orders will differ. So we will be continuously monitoring the inventory level, that is stock level of the item. Once it reaches that minimum value, then we will place the quantity, ordering quantity, to reach again the maximum level. So always, every time, we will be placing order for a definite quantity. That is continuous review model. Whereas in periodic review model, every month on a particular date we will review the inventory level. Sometimes the consumption may be more, or sometimes it may be less. If it is less, we will order for whatever is spent or consumed during that time interval. Here the time interval is fixed for periodic review model, maybe weekly or monthly or quarterly, like that. So once that ordering time is reached, by that time we will place an order, but the order quantity may differ. If the consumption is more, we will place order for more quantity. If consumption is less, we will place for lesser quantity. Here the cycle time is constant, but the quantities are different. Whereas in continuous review model, time is fixed. Quantity is fixed, but time varies. So that is how we can come across the models while solving problems. Then lead time. Lead time is the time interval between the point of placing the order and the time point of time at which the item is received. Again, this has several parts. Again, it has some components like administrative lead time. Suppose a department identifies this particular material is not available in the store, immediately they will raise for the requirement and it will reach the top management or the manager who is responsible for procurement of materials, and he will take some time to process all such requirements from different departments, and then he will decide and he will proceed for purchasing process. And once he initiates the purchasing process, then the supplier, whoever supplies the materials, he may or may not have the required quantities in stock. That means it may take immediate replenishment or supply by the supplier, or supplier may also take some time to make up the required quantities and then he will dispatch. So there is a lead time for supplier, administrative lead time is there, supplier's lead time is there. And once supplier dispatches the material, it takes some time to transship the materials from the supplier end to the company or customer end. So there is some lead time for transportation, that is transportation lead time. And once the material is received, there will be inspection of materials in respect of the quality and quantity received, and the inspection lead time is there. So once all these are over, then the material will be dispatched, or otherwise it may reach the stores, and then issue of the material will take place to the departments. So this entire time from the point of identifying the requirement for a material and raising the material requirement to the point at which the department or the end user who uses the material will receive the material, this duration is called our lead time. Then safety stock. For every material, as I said, for every material there will be a minimum and maximum levels. And that minimum level we will decide based on the lead time. Shorter the lead time, minimum order, minimum quantity will be less. Longer the lead time, the minimum stock level will be more. So we will maintain a safety stock in order to meet unexpected demand or maybe in the delay in lead times. There may be some delay in lead time also due to so many factors. Then reorder level, that means it is a level of stock which is consumed during the lead time. So for every item, for every inventory item, there will be a reorder level. So once the material reaches that level, it indicates that we have to place an order. So these are the factors influencing inventory control. Now coming to the costs, inventory costs. First one is item cost. Now we may need different types of items, and each item has some unit cost for that item, that commodity. So this is the cost of commodity. This is ordering cost, second one. To place an order, there is some cost, administrative cost involved. So that cost is called ordering cost. And this ordering cost per year depends on number of times the order is placed and cost for each order. So cost for each order multiplied by number of orders placed in a year will give you the total or annual ordering cost. Then setup cost. Suppose instead of buying, if we decide to make the material or components or sub-assemblies inside the factory itself with our existing facilities, in such case, in order to set up the machinery from starting to end till we get the component or material in the required form to make in the factory itself, some cost is involved. That cost is called setup cost, machinery setup cost. Then inventory carrying cost. This inventory carrying cost has a few components. Carrying means holding the inventory in good condition. So to hold the inventory in good condition, some cost is involved with storage, that is for storage space. Suppose if you have your own storage space, you can assume that you have taken some rented space for storing the material. So you have to calculate that rent, and then insurance, then cost of obsolescence, cost of damages, cost of leakages, cost of theft. So even though we maintain the stores in good condition, obsolescence may take place with the change of technology or some other reason, change in design or something, and there may be possibility of leakage or theft or deterioration or damage to the raw materials. So these are all possibilities. So all these costs put together is the, I mean, some insurance will be there, that cost, and the salaries paid to the stores people, and cost of maintaining the stores records and security, safety measures, everything. And all these include the inventory carrying cost, shortage cost. Suppose due to shortage of any material, if the production is stopped, then the people, the machines will be idle, workers will be idle. So some cost is there, which is which we may treat as a penalty. And that cost is called shortage cost. And then information system processing cost. So in order to maintain all the inventory records and to identify the reorder points and to process the suppliers, payments, everything. So some cost is involved to maintain the information system. So these are all different costs involved with inventory. So this is a theoretical part related to inventory control. In some other videos, I will come with different inventory models, deterministic and probabilistic models, and expressions for inventory parameters, how to arrive at the values for different parameters, and what are the controls in each model, and how that model is apt for a particular business. So thank you very much.